Hello, I'm Jonathan Slade, professor of communication and cinema here at McDaniel College, and I want to confess something to you. I really hate online education, and I suspect there's a lot of people out there that feel the same way. I've been teaching here since the beginning of my 18th year, and I've taught some online, and I much prefer face-to-face. That rolling discussion that you get, where we can see light bulbs going off around the room, that's much more difficult to find when you're online. And I know from what I talk to my students don't really care for online education. It's easy for their brains to wander, a ping here on one social media site, or a text from someone there can pull your focus. You could be distracted by a significant other or your family members. Perhaps at home you don't have great internet or wireless service or the technology that you need. There's always that bed in the corner too where you could go take a nap, right? So students struggle with online education. And parents don't care much for online education because they have many roles that they already need to be. They need to be caregiver, need to be employee. They're trying to do their own jobs and having to be surrogate teacher as well is really tough. However, many of us will not be able to have safe face-to-face classroom experiences this fall. And so that means we must resort to online education in order to keep the country and our own lives moving forward. Despite the fact that we may strongly dislike online education, really, we have to commit to it. We have to stop complaining about it. We have to stop hoping that the world is going to change for the better overnight. It's not. As imperfect as online education may be, it's the resource that we need to get the job done right now as best we can. We're all trying to navigate our way through what is really a great global trauma. How the world and norms have shifted so quickly, so radically in just a few months. And we're all trying to find ways to adapt to that. I think the worst thing to do is to cling on to nostalgia and to say that, like, well, I'm going to wait until things go back to the way they were. Well, they probably never will. So what we have to do is say, what tools do we have now and how do we put them to good use to move forward? At times like this, I think it's helpful to look back in history at other societies and how they met unprecedented challenges. And the one that comes to mind immediately, World War II and the Blitz, when Nazi Germany was bombing London. They tried to bomb London into submission, but Britain wasn't having any of it. They came up with solutions. People went to the underground, to the tube, to be safe when these bombing raids happened. They moved their airplane manufacturing plants outside of the city and hid them in rural areas. They had to live with their curtains pulled for years to make sure no light could be seen at night so the planes couldn't see the homes and the cities that were there. Ultimately, Germany gave up. They did not bomb Britain into submission, and I think you can see the resilience of the British people to this day. In the United States, there was a rationing of supplies and materials almost immediately after Pearl Harbor. Rubber was rationed for tires, and so you couldn't buy new tires just weeks after the Japanese attacked Pearl Harbor. Meat was rationed, sugar was rationed, metal, and vegetables, in fact. In one study, they said a third of all vegetables during World War II were grown in what were called victory gardens, gardens that people planted at home, on their own property, in their rooftops, in their backyards, in order to help supplement food that was potentially rationed. And make no mistake, I know it sounds like hyperbole, but that's really where we are right now. We all have to find better versions of ourselves to get through that. We all have to pick up a little bit more of the load. We all have to be more independent. We all have to do our part in order to move forward as an individual, as a student, and also as a country. And I think the best way to do that in the context of education is to find some way in your life to embrace online education. Get what you can out of it. Invest in it. Invest yourself in it. You can't just complain and yearn for the way things were. We're not going to find a way around or out of this pandemic, this public health crisis, but we can find a way through if we're all resilient, if we're all adaptable, if we're all more compassionate, if we're more flexible. We can all figure out a way to move forward with education, whether it's online or off. I like to think about when I was a young man in high school, the only car I had to drive was a Mustang II, a 1974 Mustang II, which is one of the junkiest cars you could ever imagine. No power, even though it was a Mustang. And this one leaked oil everywhere, and it had a big burn mark right in the middle of the hood because the engine caught on fire. And it was, you know, it had a weird smell in the trunk that would never go away no matter how much you tried to clean it out. But it was my transportation. And if I had said, you know what, I'm going to wait until I get a brand new car that'll take me somewhere, I would still be sitting on the farm waiting for that to happen. So I sucked it up and I said, I'll drive this car until I can get something better. And that's my own personal metaphor for why we really all need to embrace online education. It's imperfect. It's not going to accomplish everything we want to accomplish in face-to-face, but it's the tool that we have right now. And we all have to find a way to adapt and use it to our best advantage. In fact, I do believe there are some things that are good about it. I mean, the lectures, many of them are recorded, or you can record them and you can go back and replay them if you're lost. You can move at your own pace. Also, there are studies that say if you're introverted, you don't have to interact with as many people. Although I think that can sometimes lead to communication anxiety, which isn't a good thing, but there are positives to online education. Faculty has to figure out how can they interface with online education that best conveys their strengths. Students need to figure out how to interact with online education in order to keep moving forward with their studies. And parents have to figure out how to fit online education into their already overburdened life. Some students and faculty are going to be very fortunate and be able to have safe face-to-face classes, but many of us will not. So I ask for your diligence and your compassion and your hard work. We all need to step up and be more resilient, more adaptable, more of our own creative problem solvers to get through this. And that's what I'm asking of you and of myself during this semester. So let's do this thing.